In this Bluehost WordPress tutorial, I will show you step by step how to purchase and set up your hosting at the cheapest price with my secret trick. I will then show you how to register and connect your domain. And lastly, I will show you how to install and build out your WordPress website on Bluehost. So if you're a beginner and you've never built a website before, then this video is for you. At the end of this video, I'm going to give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up Bluehost through my link. I'm going to send you my six-figure blogger course for free as a way of saying thank you. This course will show you how to set up your WordPress website from start to finish. It will also show you how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance. And lastly, it will show you how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now let's get started. First, you can click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special discount page where I will show you how to get the best deal. Full transparency, this is an affiliate link. I will receive a small commission while you get a special discount and my six-figure blogger course for free. So it can be a win-win situation for both of us. And I also appreciate you supporting my channel so I can bring you more free, unbiased and unsponsored content. So you can see here the price starts from $3.95, but I'm gonna get you a much better deal than this. So let's click on get started. Here are four Bluehost shared hosting plans you can choose from. First of all, the difference between their basic and their next three plans is pretty much having unlimited websites and storage over the one website and a limited storage. So first of all, you need to decide, are you a small business or a local business that only needs one website? If so, then I just go with a basic. But if you're looking to build an agency or planning on building multiple websites, then you'll definitely need one of these three choices. Now, normally with other hosting providers, what you get extra between the medium and the top plan is that the speed of your website will increase with their optimizations. But for Bluehost, that is not the case. So what you'll get from their higher plan of the Choice Plus and the Pro is domain privacy and site backup. The site backup can be done for free using some plugins, and I've done another video to show you this. You can just search on my channel, so that's not required. And for the domain privacy, this is a bit fishy from Bluehost, to be honest, because they give you the domain for free, but then they charge you for domain privacy, which ends up being over $10, meaning that it's more expensive than going with Namecheap anyway. And then the second year, Bluehost is going to charge you for both the domain and the domain privacy, saying you're spending up to $30 a year for your domain name. And that's crazy to me, and I don't understand why no one explains and tells you this in their YouTube videos. They just want to cut out the purchase barrier so that you buy it quicker. So for me, I'm never going to suggest that you buy domain names from hosting providers, be it Bluehost, SiteGround, or anyone. It's always best and cheapest to just buy from a dedicated domain name provider like Namecheap. And I have another video here that shows you how to set this up if you need it. In this case, I'm just going to select basic. So you can either get your free domain name only for the first year, and you still have to pay for the privacy if you type in a name here and click next. But I'm gonna do it the smart way and purchase my domain name from Namecheap. So I'm gonna use my own domain. Now type here the domain name you want. Now click on next, fill out your account information here. Now we scroll down to the package information section. Now this is where I'm going to reveal the secret to you to get an awesome discount. So what you do is you hover your mouse all the way to the top of the screen, like you're going to exit it. And now a special sign up offer is presented to you, and you can get it for just $2.65. And this is my method for you to save some money. So now I'm going to click on claim savings. And if I come back down, you can see now my price is $2.65. But you will need to get it for 36 months. And that's fine with me, as once you commit with a hosting provider, you should always sign up for as long as you can, because the price per month is cheaper. And when it comes to renewal time, they always charge extra. So if you can get it for 3 years, go for it. You have the 30-day money-back guarantee at the start anyway. If you don't like them, you can refund it at the start. Now we come down to the package extra, and I recommend 100% you don't get any of these because it can be done for free with plugins. Now you can see the total price for 3 years on their basic plan is only $95. So I think that's an amazing deal in itself. Now we come down to the payment information. We fill that out. Now you agree with their terms and click submit. And here is your confirmation page. Now we can click on create your account. Put your password in and create account. Now we can log in. We put in our website domain and our password and log in. Now this is the step they take us through to create the website. So fill these out. Or if you don't really want to, we can just come down and skip this step. It's all the same. So now once you've skipped or filled out everything, then Bluehost will create your WordPress site for you. So technically our site has now been created with the domain. The next step you need to do, if you got your domain name from Namecheap like me, then you need to point the DNS to Bluehost. And what you need to do is go to domains, my domains, and you need to click on here and go to DNS. And now you can see the name servers that we need to point to is this. ns1 and ns2.bluehost.com. So I'll log in to my Namecheap account. And from the dashboard, click on manage on the domain you want. And now in the name server section, click on custom DNS and then paste in your Bluehost name servers. There was 1 and 2. And then you just click on save. Now it says this may take up to 48 hours, but this is really the case. I'd say come back in the next 5 to 10 minutes and it should be ready. It should be no more than an hour. So now my domain name has been successfully linked from Namecheap to Bluehost. We can set up our website. So now from the homepage, I'm gonna click on launch my site. Click launch my site anyway. Okay, now let's view the website. Okay, you can see here, this is our bare bones website. And we still have to do a few things to it. The first being our site is not secured, so we need to install our SSL certificate right away. So to install your SSL certificate, we go back to our homepage of our Bluehost, click on advanced, type in SSL, click on SSL/TLS. Now we select all and click run auto SSL. Success, you can see here it's been installed. Let's refresh our page and our SSL certificate is now ready to go. And now the next step is to install a plugin on our WordPress dashboard to activate this SSL. So we're gonna click on my sites. Now we're gonna click on manage site and log into WordPress. Now go to plugins and click on add new. Now search SSL and click install now on the really simple SSL plugin. Activate. And before activating our SSL, we need to make sure that our website is correct. So to do that, we go to settings, general, scroll down, and we need to change this by adding an S and making sure it's the right website link. Copy this over, paste it in here, and now we can scroll down to the bottom and click save changes. Okay, so it brings us to this page, so we need to go back to Bluehost and manage site again and click on login. And now we come back down to plugins and click on that. Now click on go ahead and activate SSL. This will make sure everything is secured on your whole website. Okay, SSL is activated and we can check this by clicking on visit site. You can see now our lock is there and it shows the certificate is valid, so our site is fully secured and our website link is also correct now. So we're ready to move on to the next step. We still have the theme installation and editing section to go, but I just wanted to ask if you're getting value out of my video so far. If so, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on similar quality content just like this that I release every single week. Now I will show you how to set up your website by installing a fast and free theme with a page editor to help you quickly edit a beautiful looking site. So what we first want to do is go to appearance and click on themes. Now scroll down and click on add new theme. In this search box, type in Astra and now click on install and activate. So now we want to click on get started. And now you see you have an option to select a page builder. I always choose Elementor as that is the one I use and I believe is the best one. So now you can see these pre-made beautiful themes you can choose for your website. So this is how I always create a website, is by finding a theme that most looks similar to what you want to create. And then you simply just change the text and the images and move things around a little bit or a lot to make what you want, right? It's much, much harder to start a full website from scratch, and no one really does that anymore these days. So you can see here from the selection, there's all sorts of websites. There's e-commerce websites, there's blog websites, there's, you know, personal training website. But I'll just go back up to the top and just pick the very first one and go from there. I think it's more like a blog website, which is what most of us want to do. So I'll click on that and click import complete site and tick delete previously imported site and now click import. Just give it a little bit of time to install all the correct plugins. And that's it, the site is ready. Let's have a quick look. Okay, you can see here, right? You have a very beautiful looking site and you only have to change a few things to get started. But of course, Elementor has free whole sections too that you can replace, for example, this part with another pre-made section template, no problems. So I'm going to start off by showing you how to change images and text. So we click on Edit with Elementor and I'm going to replace the image. But just to quickly show you, everything is very easy to edit on Elementor because you just have to hover over each of the elements. So if I hover over the text, you can just come and replace the text, which I'll change here to .com dollar, my website. And you can change things here too. But let's change the image right now. So I'm gonna click on edit section, and now I'm gonna go to style. And you see this is the image we're gonna replace. Now you click on choose image, select that, and choose the image that I want. And now I click insert media. Now you can see I have another clean image I replace and it still makes the website look really good. So you can obviously do this for all these other images and change them around to however you like it. And even buttons, you can change the text then here, or you can change the color again by clicking on the style and changing the background color to another color. Maybe I choose green. I can change my title, something like that. If you're happy with that, just make sure to always check your tablet view and your mobile view. And if everything looks in shape, then you just click on update and this will save all your changes. And of course, I go much more in depth on this in my six-figure blogger course if you decide to pick that up. But now you have a good idea of the basics and should be able to build out the website from here if you want to. So now the next thing is I'm going to show you how to edit the headers. So click on exit to dashboard, go back to our WordPress dashboard, go to appearance, themes, and now we want to customize our Astra theme. Once we are inside, we want to click on menus and click on menu here. This is where you can add or move around your pages on your header. So for example, if I want to swap around the service with about, then I just do this. Now you can see it's been swapped around. Or if I wanted to make it a subheading, then I just bring it in. And now my about page is part of my service page, see? Another thing you can do, if you want to add more pages to the menu, then you just click on add items and you can add in either pages or posts. So if I want to add in a post, just click on the post, either create a new post by typing in a new post name and press add, or just adding an existing post there. So I will add an existing post. And you can see it appears here. And if I'm happy with that, then I click on publish. So that's how we edit our menu. And if we want to change the logo, you can also come and click on here. and in the logo section, you just click on change image, go to upload files, select your files, pick your logo, and now click choose image. Now you can see here, my logo is there. If you want the size to be a bit bigger, we can move that around like this. And I'm happy with that, so I'm gonna click on publish. And the next thing I wanna show you is how to add pages or posts. So I'm gonna exit this, and I want to add a post. So I'm gonna click on post, and click on add new. And you simply just have to add your title in. So that's my title, and now my text goes here. It's that simple. But if you'd rather use a page builder like I do, then just click on edit with Elementor instead. And now you can see we're able to edit our text, add new sections. We can add anything we want. It's very flexible, and we can add videos, we can add images, anything we desire. So this is all up to you to play around with. But this is just a basic of showing you how to add a page or a post. And once you're happy, then you can either save it as a draft, or if you're ready for the world to see it, you can click on publish. And now if we go back, exit to our dashboard, and click on the view posts, you can see that our page is actually live. Now if you decide to pick up Bluehost through my link, just make sure to send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com, and I'll send you my six-figure blogger course as soon as I have confirmed your receipt. It's that simple. From this video, I'm sure you can see that Bluehost has a very intuitive backend, which is perfect for beginners. But what you may not know is that their speed and performance is not all that great. So if you decide to use Bluehost, then you need to optimize your website. And this next video is going to help you with that. So check it out, and I'll see you in the next one.